Hey Facebook, it's Rachel here. Today I'm going to do a video sermon on rebound relationships and on why I think we get into them, why I think we get into bad relationships, and all of that. But let's pray before I start. Father, fill this room, God. Do what you want to do. Say what you want to say. Use me as your vessel, Lord God. I praise you. I worship you. You are awesome. Fill my mouth with what you would have me say, what you would have me speak, what you would have me do. Lord, I praise you and bless you in the name of Jesus. Amen. Okay. Now, in typical Rachel style, I'm going to play a song just to paint a picture of a person. So this song is basically just to paint a picture. It's called Payback, and it's by Rascal Flatts. as you can see from that song, it's about a guy who sees a girl in a bar, and he knows that she has just broken up with someone, and he is just kind of ready to pounce in a way. When the Lord brought this song to me, I was like, what? You want me to do a song I want? He said, no, I don't want you to be a song condoning it, do a sermon condoning it. I just want you to say to the people out there that if they're going through this, if they're in a bound relationship, tell them for me that they don't need a rebound guy or a rebound girl. What they need is me. And I think a lot of people, when your heart is broken, you just feel so devastated. And there are one of two reactions. Either what you do is just hide away and don't talk to anybody, don't see anybody, don't communicate with anybody, or you do like the girl does in the song. You go out, you look like you're having fun, you party, you drink, you whatever, but inside that doesn't solve the problem. See, when your heart is broken, what you need to do is come to the one who can really fix your heart. And that's Jesus. He specializes in fixing the heart of anyone who asks. And I think when you break up with someone, the first thing you need to do is you need time to heal. You need time to heal, time to mourn, time to kind of get yourself back. And I think to jump into the famous adage says, when you're trying to get over a man or woman, the best thing to do is get under a new one. That's totally wrong. The best thing to do after a breakup or a broken heart is to, first of all, give it to God, and you need some time to heal. When your heart is broken, when trust is breached or whatever, it takes time to rebuild and to fix. And I think the worst mistake that anyone can make is to do what this girl did in the bar, in the song, go into a bar and look for somebody else to kind of take that pain away, because that other person won't take the pain away. They'll just either help you with it aside for a while, or make it worse depending on the person and depending on the situation. I think sometimes people are afraid to analyze themselves after a broken relationship or even broken friendship, and they act like, oh, I didn't need that person anyway, that person didn't mean a lot to me. But the truth is, they did mean a lot to you. They broke your heart, they broke your trust, or you broke their heart, or you broke their trust, or whatever happened. And you need to deal with the issues that came with that. You don't need to start saying, oh, forget about that person. You need to deal with the pain that they caused. You need to ask the Lord, what happened here? What can I learn from this relationship? Because every broken relationship, either friendship or romantic relationship, what have you, gives you lessons to learn. So instead of pretending like it doesn't matter and having him see you out with your friends at a bar or whatever, you need to find out what's going on so you don't make the same mistake again. Because often when you don't find, when you get into a rebound relationship and you don't find out what's going on, the same mistake repeats itself. And when the same mistake repeats itself, it could be worse the second time. It often is worse the second time. So my advice would be to stop, take a breather, and just give it to the Lord and say, God, I'm hurting. God, this is really, it's really hurting me. And just deal with whatever pain. Let him take you through whatever pain or whatever hurt that person caused. Don't sweep it out under the rug and pretend like you're having fun when you know you're really not. When you're at a club and you're dancing and you're partying it up and you're having fun, but inside you're like dying. You need to deal with what's going on inside. You need to deal with the residue of that relationship. And there are lessons. Life is full of lessons that we need to learn. And if you don't learn that lessons, the same reciprocal cycles will keep happening and happening and happening. And you need to find out why and what you need to learn about it. What you need to learn. Even if the breakup wasn't your fault, there is something in it for you that you need to learn. And I think the Lord would say, give it to me. Don't sweep it under the rug and don't try and hide it. Just give it to me. And I will take care of it, and I will take you through. And the process of getting over it may not be easy. It probably won't be easy. But when you get over it and see the light on the other side, you'll be so much better. You'll have so much more knowledge about yourself and how you operate. And if you don't know the Lord, I would encourage you today to get to know the Lord, because when you are thinking about a rebound relationship, there's something in there that needs to be filled. There's a reason why you are thinking about that, and the Lord can bring people into your life and help you figure out why you're going from a relationship to a relationship. And that other person will probably make you feel better for a minute, but you will still be stuck with you, and you will be stuck with the issues that caused the breakup or the breach in the first place. And the best thing to do, in my opinion, is to deal with that. Deal with what's inside. Deal with the pain. Don't lie to yourself and say that it doesn't matter. Because if it didn't matter, you wouldn't be trying so hard to make him get jealous, or you wouldn't be trying so hard to make the other woman know that you're better or whatever. You would just be okay. I think the mark of you getting over a relationship, to know that you're really over it, is when you think about that person, when somebody brings up that person's name, you feel at peace. The sign that you're not fully over a relationship is that you still feel anger, you still feel pain, you still feel hurt. And you need to give that to God. And the And the way to do that is to receive Christ into your life, because He will just make everything better. Now, the road won't be easy at times, but He's there for you, and He loves you, beloved. He loves you more than anyone ever could, more than that rebound girl or guy, more than whatever. He loves you. Get to know Him, and then He will bring you to freedom. And how you get to know him is say, Jesus, I need you. You don't need fancy words. You don't need what we call the sinner's prayer. You don't need anybody to pray to you. Just say, Jesus, if you're real, reveal yourself to me. And He will. Let me see if I have time. I only have 20 minutes, so let's see if I have time to play another song. I don't know if I do or not. I hope I do. Oh, yes, I do. The song that I'm going to play is called Lifeline. It's by Mandisa.